of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters, in our liturgy of today, we read about Zacchaeus, one who was transformed after his encounter with Christ. We too have come to encounter Jesus in the Holy Eucharist. We pray that the transformation that comes from him may truly be ours, both now and forever. To prepare ourselves to celebrate this sacred mystery worthy, let us call to mind our sins and ask God for pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, blessed Mary, ever virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Maccabees. In those days, Eleazar, one of the scribes in high position, a man now advanced in age and of noble presence, was being forced to open his mouth and eat swine's flesh. But he, welcoming death with honor rather than life with pollution, went up to the rack of his own accord, spitting out the flesh, as men ought to go who have the courage to refuse things that it is not right to taste, even for the natural love of life. Those who were in charge of that unlawful sacrifice took the man aside because of their long acquaintance with him, and privately urged him to bring meat of his own providing, proper for him to use, and pretend that he was eating the flesh of the sacrificial meal which had been commanded by the king, so that by doing this he might be saved from death and be treated kindly on account of his old friendship with them. But making a high resolve, worthy of his years and the dignity of his old age, and the gray hairs which he had reached with distinction, and his excellent life, even from childhood, and moreover, according to the holy God-given law, he declared himself quickly, telling them to send him to Hades. Such pretense is not worthy of our time of life, he said, lest many of the young should suppose that Eleazar, in his 90th year, has gone over to an alien religion, and through my pretense, for the sake of living a brief moment longer, they should be led astray because of me, while I defile and disgrace my old age. For even if for the present I should avoid the punishment of men, yet whether I live or die, I shall not escape the hand of the Almighty. Therefore, by manfully giving up my own life, I will show myself worthy of my old age, and leave to the young a noble example of how to die a good death, willingly and nobly, for the revered holy laws. When he had said this, he went at once to the rabbi. And those who a little before had acted towards him with goodwill now changed to ill will, because the words he had uttered were, in their opinion, sheer madness. When he was about to die under the blows, he groaned aloud and said, "It is clear to the Lord in his holy knowledge that though I might have been saved from death, I am enduring terrible suffering in my body under this beating. But in my soul, I am glad to suffer these things because I fear him." So in this way, he died, leaving in his death an example of nobility and a memorial of courage, not only to the young, but to the great body of his nation. The word of the Lord. The Lord upholds me.
The Lord
upholds
me.
How many are my foes, O Lord? How many are rising up against me? How many are saying about me, "There is no help for him in God"?
The Lord upholds me.
But you, Lord, are a shield about me. My glory will lift up my head. I cry aloud to the Lord. From his holy mountain, he answers me.
The Lord upholds me.
I lie down, I sleep and I wake, for the Lord upholds me. I will not fear even thousands of people who are ranged on every side against me. Arise, Lord, save me, my God. Alleluia, for the Lord God omnipotent reigneth. Alleluia, alleluia. Sent his Son to be the expiation for our sins. Alleluia.
Alleluia, for the Lord God, omnipotent reigneth. Alleluia, alleluia, praise the Lord. Alleluia, for the Lord God, omnipotent reigneth. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. And there was a man named Zacchaeus, who was a chief tax collector and rich. And he sought to see who Jesus was, but could not on account of the crowd, because he was small of stature. So he ran on ahead and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for I must stay at your house today." So he made haste and came down and received him joyfully. And when they saw it, they all mourned, "He has gone in to be the guest of a man who is a sinner." And Zacchaeus stood and said to the Lord, "Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor, and if I have defrauded anyone of anything, I restore it fourfold." And Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, since he also is the son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of the Holy Gospel lead us safe to eternal life.
Amen.
Good afternoon, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Our Gospel reading of today shares some similarities with that of yesterday. Remember, yesterday's Gospel was the experience, the encounter of the blind man with Jesus on his way to Jericho. Now, similarities in the sense that Zacchaeus, like this blind man, encounters Christ. And after this encounter, there is a transformation that follows thereafter. But there are certain dissimilarities that they also share. First is in the manner of approach, in the way they encountered Christ. The reaction of the crowd, or the role of the crowd in both narratives. My dear brothers and sisters, beginning with the role of the crowd, we must note that unlike the crowd of yesterday who tried to hinder the blind man from meeting Christ, today's crowd played a passive role in hindering Zacchaeus from meeting the Lord Jesus Christ. If you recall, they tried to shut the blind man up when he was shouting, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." But Zacchaeus, the crowd were also eager to see Christ, but Zacchaeus could not. Not because of the crowd, but because he was small in stature. He was short in the real sense of the word. My dear brothers and sisters, the story of Zacchaeus is the story of each and every one of us. There is a limitation, there is something that hinders us from meeting Christ. Not something external of us, but something internal in us. Something that is created in us that always hinders us from meeting Christ. It might not be the case of our height like the case of Zacchaeus. It might be a spiritual dwarfism, a spiritual small stature that we might have. And so there is a need for us to look for something to elevate us so as to meet Christ. Now Zacchaeus understands that Jesus will pass a certain way, and he runs on ahead and climbs a sycamore tree. He needed something to elevate him. He needed something to enable him to meet Christ. So also we too need something to enable us to meet Christ. We need something to enable us also encounter him. Recall that when Christ sees him on the sycamore tree, Zacchaeus was not called out to Christ. Rather, it was Christ who called upon Zacchaeus and asked him to come down from the sycamore tree to meet him. To show that in as much as we want to meet Christ, Christ is all the more willing to meet each and every one of us. And that is where the last statement of our Gospel reading becomes very relevant. That the Son of Man has come to even call those who are lost. My dear brothers and sisters, back to the issue of the sycamore tree. We too need a sycamore tree in our lives to be able to encounter Christ. You may be wondering, what is a sycamore tree? What must we climb to be able to reach Christ? There are various things that have been put before us to enable us to reach this goal. One of which is the Holy Eucharist, the celebration of the Mass. At the Mass, we come to listen to God speak to us. At the Mass, we come to receive His own very body and blood. It is only in the Mass that we can encounter Him in two forms, in His Word and both in His flesh and blood. The Mass also helps us to encounter, because it is in the Mass that Christ will tell us to come, that He is going to our hearts, He is going to our homes today. How often do we spend time, how often do we make sacrifice in reading the sacred scriptures? How often do we share the word of God in our families? This is where also we can encounter, or we can elevate ourselves to encounter Christ. The various sacraments that have been given to us, the sacrament of penance which has been given to us, is also an opportunity for us to encounter Him. Baptism, confirmation, these are various ways which we have been given to touch, for Christ to touch each and every one of us. Adoration, the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament, we come not only to speak to Him, but also to listen to Him speak to us. My dear brothers and sisters, these are events, these are various categories of forms which God continues to give us opportunity to encounter him. So it is important that we do not take these things for granted. It is important that we are willing, like Zacchaeus, to leave the crowd, run on ahead, and climb the sycamore tree so as to encounter him. Now notice what happens thereafter. After the encounter, Zacchaeus was no longer the same person. He was transformed. Every encounter with Christ should bring about a transformation. Every encounter with Christ should bring about something new in our lives. How often have we come for Mass and after Mass there is nothing that has changed in us? How often have we read the scriptures and after that there is nothing that has been transformed in us? Then we begin to ask ourselves, what is it that we have just done? Today in our recent time there is the growing trend of people of the ideology that we do not need to read the scriptures or we do not need to go to church to become spiritual beings. People are gradually shifting religion aside, not because they want to, but because they feel that it has been so corrupted that it cannot influence or affect their lives. Now that something has been created to be good and has been adulterated to become bad does not mean that everything about it is bad. There is a need for us to look inward. There is a need for us to discern properly and ask ourselves what are the good things we have to take out from there. Jesus, every now and then, wants to encounter each and every one of us. We cannot say that we will stay amongst the crowd and allow him to encounter us. He needs us to make certain sacrifices. He needs us to climb the sycamore tree. He needs us to make that first step in coming close to him so that he too will say to us, come down, I am going to your home today. So my dear brothers and sisters, let us pray at this Mass that the good Lord would continue to transform our lives for the better, that he would continue to heal each and every one of us of our spiritual small stature, and would continue to grant us the grace to live meaningfully and worthily, so that at the end of our lives here on earth, we may truly join him and his angels in that eternal banquet which he has prepared for us. We make all these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add not into your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the powers of angels, we praise you as with joy we proclaim.
Holy.
The fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Alfred Martins, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Now the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may Mary to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, called by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. And by the help of your mercy, we will always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
An act of contrition, O my God, because sin is no good, may I bring sorrow and sweet against you. By the help of your grace, I will want to sing with you.
God.
sacrament was holy, O sacrament divine, all grace and all thanksgiving, be in every moment time. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all grace and all thanksgiving, be in every moment time. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all grace and all thanksgiving, be in every moment time. Jesus, I love you. All I have is yours. Yours I am. Yours I want to be. Do with me whatever you will. Jesus, I love you. All I have is yours. Yours I am. Yours I want to be. Do with me whatever you will. Jesus, I love you. All I have is yours. Yours I am. Yours I want to be. Do with me whatever you will. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, and ever shall be, for us and our world. Saint Philip and James.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery. Humbly implore, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you all and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.